could do this with techniques like this, but also by crowdsourcing. And one of the things we did, I would like to share with you, introduced by a little video. We got navigation controls in our car, we maybe even got it in our cell phone. We perfectly know where all the ADMs are, just about this city of Maastricht. The other thing is we know where all the gas stations are. And sure, we could find fast food chains. But where would be the nearest AED to help this patient? We asked around and nobody knew. Nobody knew where the nearest AED, life-saving AED, was to obtain right now. So what we did, we crowdsourced the Netherlands and we set up a website and asked the crowd, if you see an AED, please submit it. Tell us where it is. Tell us when it's open, since sometimes in office hours it's closed, of course. And moreover than 10,000 AEDs in the Netherlands already have been submitted. The next step we took was find applications for it, and we built an iPad application. We made an application for layer, augmented reality, to find these AEDs. And whenever you were in a city like Maastricht and somebody collapsed, you can use your iPhone. And within the next weeks, also on your Microsoft cell phone to find the nearest AED which can save lives. And as of today, we would like to introduce this not only as AED for you, which is the product called, but also AED for us. And we would like to start this on a worldwide level and asking all colleagues of us in basically the rest of the world, colleague universities to help us to find and work and act like a hub to crowdsource all these AEDs around the world, that whenever you're on holiday and somebody collapses, might it be your own relative or someone just in front of you, you can find this. The other thing we'd like to ask is companies also all over the world that will be able to help us validate these AEDs. This might be courier services or cable guys, for instance, just to see whether the AED that's submitted still is in place. So please help us.